In Washington this morning, Congress is ready to approve a controversial oil pipeline. Democrats blocked it for 6 years. The House is expected to vote today on the Keystone XL project. Senate Democrats changed their position. They say the Senate will vote next week. Nancy Cordes is on Capitol Hill with the story behind that sudden turnaround. Nancy, good morning.
Good morning. Well, you will not be surprised to hear that it is all about politics and Democrats trying to save the seat of Democratic Senator Mary Landrieu, whose race has gone to a runoff and she's trailing in the polls. Louisiana is an oil and gas state. The pipeline is very popular there. And so Democratic leaders thought that giving Senator Landrieu something that she has been demanding for years might boost her chances back at home. Landrieu herself insisted that this has nothing to do with politics.
If taking my name off of this bill helps it to pass, go right ahead. This is not about credit. It is not about glory. It is not about politics. It is about getting our work done.
Republicans, of course, want to deny Landrieu the credit, and so they promptly announced that the House will vote on its own Keystone pipeline bill, which they are calling, I'm serious, the Cassidy Keystone solution after Landrieu's opponent, Louisiana Congressman Bill Cassidy. Traveling in Asia, White House officials pointed out that the president has vowed to veto similar legislation in the past, and they said his views have not changed, that he still believes that the State Department, not Congress, should determine if this project goes forward. Democrats have long had concerns about the environmental impact of the pipeline, but they frankly see the writing on the wall, which is that Republicans are going to pass it right away as soon as they take control of the Senate. In January. Nora.
All right, Nancy, thank you so much.